nurse or the sexy vampire or the sexy zombie, you know, the sexy, 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 sexy. And, you know, should you or shouldn't you? Now, my kind of thing in life in general is if you're asking, should I or is it appropriate, it probably means you shouldn't and it's not a good idea. But if you still have that question, you know, I'll just give a couple little tips to help with, you know, you want to be participatory, you want to not be like a stick in the mud, but you also want to keep it respectable, keep it modest. Now, of course, if you, you know, work in a adult industry, for example, or you already dress kind of more in revealing outfits already, then obviously this has nothing to do with you, you know, just continue to do what you do. But if you don't work in an adult industry or in a environment where you have to not wear revealing outfits, then, you know, this next few tips might help. And then, of course, especially, you know, and I do want to give these tips because, you know, if you want to climb a corporate ladder or if you already are on top of the corporate ladder and if you're a manager, you know, you don't want to ever have people come back and say, ooh, can you believe that they wore this outfit? Because if you were inappropriate in any way, I promise you that people will come back and talk about you year after year after year. And you want people to talk about you in a positive way, not in, can you believe she had her whole behind or all her cleavage outside? She should have known, or he should have known, that they shouldn't have done that. Probably an easy way is to keep it kid friendly. What would you wear to a kid friendly event? So this would mean either maybe doing a mask. It might be doing your makeup a little differently, like a little bolder than you normally would. For example, like even today, like the lipstick that I'm wearing, I normally wouldn't wear something so bold, but I did today, and I just literally outlined it with black lipstick, filled it in with this glittery purple lipstick, and then I highlighted the center with this cute, yummy, opaque gloss, and then just, you know, whatever. And so if you want to do something, you don't want to worry about costumes, but you want to maybe just make your makeup a little more dramatic or more kind of, that would be as if you were doing an evening look at your day job, that's a perfect way to add a little oomph for Halloween. Another also great way is earrings. Like I did a post, and I think if you go back, you'll see my posts. Another great way is to do some cute Halloween earrings. I got these a whole bunch, I think like six or eight pairs or something like that on Amazon. And I got a whole stack of Halloween themed earrings that I literally pull out once a year, or I guess now twice a year or three times a year, however many times I feel like in October I want to wear them. And I just have a bunch of cute Halloween themed earrings to wear. Another easy costume. So you can wear your regular clothes, but just throw on a pair of cute little Halloween themed earrings. Super simple. And then, of course, I wore this last year, but my jack-o'-lantern themed shirt. That's literally what I wore last year, was this black leggings, my Halloween themed jack-o'-lantern shirt. And that was it. That's all I wore. So, if you want to go ahead and wear like a full costume, or do like face paint, like you maybe want to do like a clown, you're wearing a clown outfit, you want to do a whole face paint, absolutely. But if you don't want to take it that far, then you don't have to. And then also you have to remember too, with your costumes, you got to sit in them all day, right? So if you're going to be commuting to work, at work, and then commuting home, is this outfit comfortable? Is the face paint going to start like crumbling off halfway through the day? Am I going to have to keep retouching it throughout the day? Along with, do I really want to be a sexy nurse? And every time you bend over all day, you have to worry about your butt showing, like. So there's just a few different ideas. Obviously, go ahead with a traditional outfit, but you can keep it to a themed shirt, maybe some vampy makeup. Some people even do like they just wear their regular clothing, and they may do like a zombie look on their face. Like they like really 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 have really great makeup skills, and they can do like special effects. So they'll dress how they normally dress in their regular, business suit, and then have like, like a big wound on their head. And so there's so many different ways. Like just go on YouTube and there's tons and tons of different Halloween costume outfits, and even just type in appropriate work Halloween costumes and tons of stuff will come up. But again, like I said earlier, if you're not sure and you want to be safe, just think kid-friendly costumes for work, and you'll find something. If you ever participated in Halloween, what is one of your Halloween treats? Like, do you like the caramel popcorn, or do you like the candied apples? Do you like what else do we have? Like the just the little mini, whether it was a mini Kit Kat, mini Reese's.